You're probably wondering why I'm not releasing a normal video today, and that's totally fine, because I've been on a streak with like the gaming videos and Let's Plays and stuff. But I really just wanted to get outside and clear my head, you know? There's been a lot going on in my life, especially with quarantine and everything, and it's been a struggle. And I kind of just wanted to talk about how important it is to de-stress and just get out and do something different, because I've been doing the same thing a lot, and this is the first I've really gotten out and done anything different, so it's kind of nice. So I am at that overpass where I filmed that vlog a couple years ago when I was like 14. You can see it kind of outside there. That's where it was. I haven't been here in a while. I shouldn't say that. I was here a couple weeks ago because I walked Ollie, but I didn't do a video with that. But I haven't like been here and just stayed here in a while, so I think that's what I might do today. It's just kind of nostalgic for me, and I spent a lot of time here when I was 14 or whatever, and I spent a lot of time in my thoughts and thinking, and it's kind of my safe place to go to just think, you know? So that said, I'm not going to go far. I am just going to... Oh, hello, wind. Lock? Okay. I'm just going to stay put here-ish, and I'm not going to go far. I'm just going to talk. This is really weird being back. This is my hobo spot, I call it.
Hobo spot.
Here we are. It's important to de-stress in life. Sorry, that's very shaky. But I've been really stressed with everything, and not... YouTube's been stressing me a little bit, but it's something I love to do, so if anything, it's more of a stress reliever, and it's been really... I'm really blessed to have that, and I really appreciate it. But, like, school... School's been pretty nuts. I'm a junior this year, obviously, so people driving by looking at me weird, that's fine though. I'm a junior, this is my second to last year, so junior year's been pretty rough. So I've been pretty stressed with everything going on in my life, mostly school. School's been rough. YouTube hasn't been stressing me at all. I've been uploading videos every single day for the past month and a half, no, a month or so, about a month. So that's been really nice. It's honestly been more of a stress reliever than anything for me. But it's... I just wanted to get outside again and just kind of not do anything crazy. I haven't been here and just sat in about 3 years, and it's nice. So I had school today. I had a co-op that I'm in for a homeschool group. It's basically a bunch of homeschoolers just getting together, and we do school. It's like public school, but it's homeschoolers. I don't know. It's confusing. But we use Zoom, obviously, because of the quarantine, and it was... Everybody was just a little bit off today for whatever reason, today of all days, because it's not the first time we've done this during quarantine, but people are just agitated, I think. So there was a lot of tension, and I could feel a lot of tension, and it just made me think about what's going on, and like, this is very hard, and it's a very difficult situation that we're in, because we've never seen anything like this in recent years, and it's been a bit difficult to adjust to it. So yeah, like between classes there was some little bit of arguing, I guess you could call it. It didn't... I don't know, people are just agitated, and it's really... it's not fun. Nobody's happy with this. Nobody wants this to happen, and so here I am coping with it. This is how I cope. I like my alone time. I'm introverted, so I just go sit by myself with my thoughts, or just, I don't know, just sit somewhere. But yeah, I got school, I got personal life stuff, things that are going on. It's been a little bit difficult the past couple days especially, but that's okay. It's a-okay. It's very cold outside. I didn't realize how cold it was, or else I might not have done this, but it's not even 50 degrees, and I'm just out here chilling under a bridge that has no sunlight. Sorry if it's loud. There's... obviously I'm under an overpass, and there's a lot of big cars driving over, so that's fun. I don't even know what to talk about. I've been frustrated a little bit with, like, life circumstances and the quarantine, because today I was supposed to go to, I'd be going to Louisville, Kentucky right now, for the World Championship in robotics. And that's obviously not happening because the whole thing got canceled due to this. I never thought it would get, like... I remember hearing about Corona when it was in China, and I never thought it would get to the US, and until it did, and it was all so abrupt, and then that got canceled, and it was like... I wasn't so much like upset because of that, Obviously, I'm upset because it got canceled and I wanted to go to Worlds because I was actually competing at the World Championship level in robotics for the first time. But there's like people who were at Worlds who mean a lot to me who I haven't seen. This one person specifically who I haven't seen in about a year. And she means a lot to me. And you probably know what the relationship there is, but yeah. Haven't seen her in about a year, and I was supposed to see her there, and that's not happening now. So that, it's difficult. It's very, very difficult, and it bugged me, and it bothers me a lot, but I'm getting through it. We're good. And so I'm coping now, because I didn't think, like, obviously I found out that it wasn't going to happen a while ago, but it's hard today, especially knowing that, like, it would have happened today, but it's not. And instead I'm sitting under an overpass in under 50 degree weather filming myself talking as some runner is walking over here, so that's super awkward. I've had a lot of built up stress inside that's built up, and that kind of pushed me over because it's a big thing and it means a lot to me, and it's kind of my whole life, so it really means a lot, and it's been really tough, but that's why I'm here to cope. So I wanted to talk to you guys, and maybe you can relate. Like, you've got a lot of stress that's building up with this, and you got all this stuff built up inside. You don't know what to do with it. What do you do with it? Go do something physical. Like, you got all this energy. You got to do something with it, because if you leave it, then it's just going to burn a hole in your heart, and you're just going to be all like, I don't even know. You're going to be very damaged. It's not going to be fun. It's going to be an emotional roller coaster like it already is. And there's the mailman. Wow, there are a lot of people here. For me, I've been working out a lot more. And that's another way that I cope with it. I used to, like, be serious, like, super serious. There was a little phase. Excuse me, sir. I'm trying to film a video. Gosh. I went through this phase where I was, like, super into WWE, which is World Wrestling Entertainment, which is professional wrestling, which is, like, basically a bunch of bodybuilders-type dudes getting wrestling. I still like it. I think it's pretty entertaining, and I think it'd be fun to do. But I was super into that for a while, and I wanted to, like, I didn't want to do professional bodybuilding, but I wanted to, like, work out and get to that level. And so I started doing that very seriously, and I stuck to it for like a month or two, and I was doing really good. This was all like immediately before the quarantine. So yeah, I was eating a lot of food and really bulking up, and this is not even relevant to the story, but my point is, the quarantine happened, I got super sick a couple times, and I lost like 10 pounds that I gained just from being sick and like quarantining. And so now I'm back to square one, which is right where I started beforehand, and I'm really kind of ticked off about that, but it's okay. So a couple days ago I decided, you know what, I need to like get off my butt, because that's all I've been doing between school and YouTube is sitting on my butt all day, and I need to do something. And so that's what I started doing. I started working out and exercising a lot, and that still wasn't enough today with everything that happened. So like this morning I worked out a lot, and it was like a lot, and I was really sore from that, but it still wasn't enough. And so that's why I'm here talking to y'all and just sitting and chilling, because that's what I do, and I'm introverted, and that's how I cope with stuff. So yeah, that's basically all this video is about, is just why this is all you're getting from me today. Unless it's not, I might decide to go back home and do some Slender or SCP or whatever. I know you guys want more SCP, but here's the thing with that. I've been thinking, I'm trying to move on. I did the Unity remake, obviously, but I don't want to just stick to one game or one game series in everything that I do on the channel. Because I'm not just exclusively an SCP channel, I'm not exclusively a Slender channel, and I'm not exclusively an indie horror channel. I'm not exclusive to anything. I like to make it a variety. I like to do sketches and film stuff, and that's just the way it is. I'm not going to stick to one thing. Will I play SCP again? Probably, yeah, I'd really like to do it, but I'm not going to do stuff that I don't want to do, and I know that sounds selfish, but if I'm not interested in playing a game, then why is somebody going to be interested in watching me play that game, you know? Like, if I'm not at all interested in that game, I'm obviously not going to have a good time playing it. And not to say I'm not interested in SCP, because I am, I just don't know if I will be. And I want to get some other stuff out of the way first, like some indie games that people are waiting on me to play, like developers and whatnot, so I gotta get back to that and do that first. It definitely takes up a lot of my thoughts, because I really love doing YouTube. and it takes up a lot during my day. And yeah, it's a little bit, it's not, I don't want to say it's dangerous, but it's a little bit dangerous when I think about YouTube so much, because it does interfere with school and it gets in my mind and whatnot, and it's like I can't focus on that because I'm always thinking about YouTube and the next video and all that sort of stuff. But now I got a lot going on, and I just like, it's been a, it's cool. I don't even know. School's been a disaster. I had a lot going on today because I had to do an assignment in between classes on my lunch break, and that didn't go well because I had to read a little paragraph thing, and I like couldn't, I could not think. Like I tried as hard as I could, and I just couldn't think about it because I have so much going on in my mind, and yeah. But, big but, don't worry about me. I'll be fine. I'm getting through it. This happens a lot. But I'll be okay. So, yeah, I don't want you guys to, like, think I'm crying for help or something, because I'll be fine. I have obviously dealt with, I've talked about this before, like, in my past, in my younger years, about 3 years ago, actually, I was dealing with a lot of, like, depression stuff, and it was pretty bad. I was never, like, full-on suicidal where I committed suicide, but I had a lot of suicidal thoughts, like, a lot of them, and it's, like, it was just this dark cloud that just constantly, like, it was anywhere I went, it was there. And like, yeah, on the outside I could seem happy and like I'm having a good time, but it was very forced and it was never legitimate, I guess. So I was a very different person then. I'm a very different person now because I've obviously moved on from that and I've learned a lot and I've overcome it. So that's good. I mean, everybody gets depressed and those thoughts I don't think go away when you, like, it's not like I don't get those thoughts anymore. It's not the suicidal ones, but it's not like I don't feel like that. I just want life to be done and I'm just like tired of it, because everybody gets that. Let's face it, everybody has those thoughts. But what's important is that we don't act on it, because we don't want to act on it, because that's not good. And it's, you know, this is a very touchy topic for some people, but suicide is not, it's not good. It's the easy way out. It's not legitimately dealing with your problems, because the best way to deal with your problems is to face your problems and solve them, and suicide's not doing that. It's taking the easy way out. It's just giving up, basically. And I think I can speak for most people when I say that giving up is not exactly how we should live, and that's not how we should, yeah, it's not how we should live our lives. We shouldn't be giving up on anything, no matter what it is, and no matter what you have to do. So yeah, this is just me rambling about random stuff. I don't know, it might not make any sense to you guys, but that's just kind of my thought process right now. And there's a lot going on in my thought process, but I'm just going to be here for a little bit longer. Maybe it's getting kind of cold. I might go sit in the car. I don't know. Actually, I'm going to go sit in the car, yeah. But first, I would like to give you a tour of my overpass area. Well, my overpass area. So this is my main spot where I sit. It's kind of, I don't know, it's kind of homey a little bit. That was my main overpass. There's also that side over yonder. Ooh, wow, look at that. There's also over there, and there's also over there. So that's where I spent the majority of my life when I was 14 years old, 3 years ago. Oh my gosh, it's cold. And I got in on the passenger side for whatever reason, so give me just a second here to get on the driver's side. Oh boy. And here we are, driver's seat. Activated. I'm gonna turn the car on because it's cold. What I was saying a second ago before I rudely interrupted myself and left is that basically this is just all my thoughts that are happening. Hopefully it'll make some sort of sense when I put this all together in the editing. I just want it to be productive to you guys and hopefully something you can take away from this. If there's anything at all, maybe you're struggling with this. If you are, please let me know. Like, reach out via a YouTube comment or the Twitter. Like, you guys can DM me on Twitter, I think. Let me know if you can't DM me on Twitter, because that would be a problem and I can fix that. Because I'd love to talk to you guys about anything. Like, I know I'm not qualified in any way to give counseling or stuff, but I do love talking to people and helping people who go through this sort of thing, because I've gone through that sort of thing. And this is very wobbly. And so I want to make my best effort to help you, to help you through it. So that's what I'm trying to say. So if you're struggling with this, either leave me a comment, or if you want to make it personal, you can like DM me on Twitter or Instagram or all that sort of fun stuff. And I'll do my best to get back to you. So yeah, I think that's where I'm going to end this video. I'm just going to sit here maybe a couple of minutes longer. I might just drive around a little bit, honestly, because driving is fun and it clears my mind, so I might do that. So thank you guys for watching this video if you're still here. I really appreciate it, and yeah, I hope you all are doing well and staying safe during this quarantine. It's rough and tough, but we will get through it together as one. Hoo-yah! That's all I wanted to say to you guys, so thank you for watching, and I just want to thank you guys for all your support and everything you've done for me, because the channel's obviously been growing a lot at an astronomical rate, which is almost unheard of for a channel this size, and I'm very proud of each and every one of you, and I really, really appreciate everything that you guys have done for me. Just by watching my videos, it means the world to me, and I can't thank you enough. So thank you so much. I got such a big heart for you guys, and I appreciate each and every one of you so much, because this is my dream, for those of you who don't know, to do YouTube as like a full-time thing. And I'd love to get involved with other content creators and do stuff with them, but this is my dream. It's a crazy dream. I'm dreaming high. I'm aiming high for dreams. But you guys are helping to make that a reality slowly but surely. So I'm not expecting anything to happen, because I'm not planning on anything to happen. But if it were to happen, I would not be opposed to that. So that's basically what's popping. Yeah. So I want to thank each and every one of you guys. Even if you're like not even subscribed, but just watching it, it helps, believe it or not, because when somebody watches a video, then YouTube's like, oh hey, somebody's watching this video, so I'm gonna promote this video a little bit more. So yeah, I really appreciate that. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see all of y'all in the next one. Stay frosty, folks. Bye.